Good morning, YouTubers. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me. At 8:48 a.m. East Coast time, or 5:48 West Coast time, there was a magnitude 6.3 earthquake off the coast of South America. It was along the Nazca Plate, 6.2 miles below sea level. All earthquakes are measured from sea level. There was a little bit of spreading here. The fault moved going towards the northwest and also towards the southwest. And this is an area of spreading. You can see that there. Here on Geoscope, you can see how the fault moved during the earthquake. And then also here, down here at the bottom, it shows you going southwest. Yeah, the moment tensor ball doesn't really show spreading. But, yeah, if you see how the fault moved, going northwest here, and then southwest here, yeah, you know it's spreading. This earthquake made the earth ring like a bell. Here it is as it came in at Hockley, Texas. Massachusetts, South Dakota. Yeah, during that time, my cat was meowing. I thought, what's wrong with you? Pennsylvania, Tennessee. Indiana, Ohio, Minnesota, New York, another monitor for Texas, Montana, and over here on the left is Virginia. Yeah, it made Yellowstone ring too. Here we have Madison River at the top. The next one down is Holmes Hill. This one here, I'm still waiting for it to connect to get the data. But then the other one down here at the bottom, that would be Little Thumb Creek, Little West Thumb, or West Thumb along Yellowstone Lake. Yeah, so far the data looks like it was the strongest coming in at Holmes Hill. And that would be the Madison River area, which we know they've had a lot of earthquakes. Let's go to see what it's showing right now. Okay, let's pull it over. Want to see if it possibly could trigger some earthquakes there at Yellowstone. We got one right there, it looks like. What we have going on here besides the spreading is the Nazca Plate slowly moving over here towards the east, moving underneath the South American Plate. So giving it some thought about the movement of the plate, it probably put pressure up here on the Cocos Plate. And, yeah, I don't know. What is that going to do? Where will the next earthquake happen? We'll just have to wait and see. It's currently 17 degrees Fahrenheit there at Yellowstone, and the camera's not working. There is a static image of Old Faithful taken at 8:44 a.m. Right there. Yeah, that looks dirty back over there. Look at that. Let me make that bigger. Okay, and I'll pull it over so you can see it. Yeah, looks a little dirty. Geysers along the back boardwalk, they look dirty too. All right, let's pull this over. No tsunami warning for Hawaii, and no tsunami warning for Alaska, British Columbia, Washington, Oregon, and California. Yeah, based on the information in historic tsunami records, the earthquake is not expected to generate a tsunami. Here on the National Buoy Warning Center, yeah, you can see, well, there's so many of them that aren't working. I mean, we spent all this money sending men to the moon, trying to get to Mars, and all this other space stuff, but we can't keep earthquake monitors and buoys working. Yeah, there's nothing going off around the world. Yeah, let me go over here. So that's good news. As you know, as the Earth's magnetic field weakens, yep, we're seeing an increase in earthquakes and adverse weather. Yeah, it does affect our jet stream. and volcanic eruptions. I'll give you a link to this. This is currentvolcanoesandearthquakes.com, but I got it just on the volcanoes that are currently here. We got one in Central America. Let me try and make this bigger. Okay, let's go, because there's some that are really close to each other. Okay, Central America. I'm not gonna try and pronounce these. Malaysia. Where is that? Colombia, Ecuador. Another one in Ecuador. Near Bolivia, it looks like. Chile. And let's bring it over for you guys. Okay, in the Mediterranean Sea. This one here I already reported. There by Italy. And we got another one. Yeah, that's by the Red Sea. I did not know about that. Ethiopia. I'm going to try and pull this out a little bit. Oh, I guess I can't. Let's see. The Congo. Tanzania. Let's see here. Yeah, I zoomed in and now I can't zoom back out. Okay, so we got down here by Australia. Let's see, this one's orange. So they must be on alert. Indonesia. Java, Indonesia. Let's see. Yeah, I don't know where that one's at. Another one for Indonesia. We got another one on orange in the Philippines. Papua New Guinea. There's a lot of them, isn't there? Yeah, you wouldn't think there was that many volcanoes around the world that were actually erupting. I don't know if I can. Maybe I can bring this out. There we go. Okay. Let me come out a little bit farther. Okay. Up there by Japan. Looks like there's two. Kilauea. I'm always saying I'm pronouncing it wrong. But you guys know what I'm talking about. That's Hawaii, and they're currently watching Mauna Loa there. Let's see. Got another one. Let's zoom in a little bit. Off the coast there, south of Japan. We got two. Yeah. And we got another one that's orange. That's a lot of volcanoes, isn't it? I guess you could go through and count them all. Along the Aleutian Islands, we got several on orange alert. Let's see. Great Sicken. Let's see, what's this one? Pavlov. Nothing up here, which I'm surprised. Yeah, one day we'll have one over here for Yellowstone. So what are your thoughts? Put your comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless you.